If you're buying a new espresso machine, there are a lot of factors to consider, and one of the biggest and probably the most important is the boiler. What are the differences between the different types, and is one better for you? Well, let's find out. Hello, my name is Stephen Holm and I'm with Homegrounds. And before I jump into the video, I'm just gonna ask really quick, if you are new around here, if you wouldn't mind subscribing, liking this video, leaving a comment down below. Those all really help us being able to make you more and more coffee videos just like this. So today we are talking about espresso machine boilers. There's a lot of different types on the market, so we're gonna talk about some of the pros and cons of each and which one might be best for you. To start off, let's talk about the thermocoil / thermoblock / single boiler. Those are all kind of different things, but I'm gonna lump them all into one category because they all sort of work on the same basic principle. Basically, you just have one element in your espresso machine that is heating up the water both for brewing and steaming. So this is an example of a thermocoil. How this works is we have sort of four inlets going into this big solid mass. We have two of which are heating elements and then two of which are water. So we have a water input and that water is going to go through a coil inside of this mass, which is being heated via these heaters, duh. And that water is going to get hotter and hotter until it exits out of the coil and it is ready to either brew or steam with. Now, one benefit with these is they are fairly inexpensive to produce. It's definitely the cheapest way to heat up water in an espresso machine. They have a relatively small footprint. This one is from the Brewsly espresso machine. It was from our cheap versus expensive video. But these can be slightly bigger, such as in the Breville Barista Express that I have right here. Now you can see in here that we have our thermoblock or thermocoil up at the top. You can see that this one is a lot larger. But basically, they are doing the same thing. They are heating up your water by its surrounding elements, and so it can vary quite a bit. You're not gonna get a super precise temperature. And then our biggest problem comes when we want to switch between brewing espresso and steaming milk, because we only have one heating element in these machines, and the temperature differences for brewing espresso versus steaming are very different. And so whenever we want to go from brewing espresso to steaming milk, we have to usually flip a switch in the machine. In the Breville, it's here on the side, and that is going to trigger the heating elements to go even hotter. And so it takes sometimes between 30 seconds up to a minute in order to get that water up to temperature in order to steam. So you are not able to brew espresso and steam milk at the same time. And then once you're done steaming milk, if you want to go back to brewing temperature, you have to, let's say, flip the switch back and wait for the machine to cool down the water in there. You can sometimes speed that up by purging the group head, allowing really, really hot water to come out. That will get you there a little bit quicker, but that's probably the biggest disadvantage to these machines. Along with not being able to do a super precise temperature, but in some machines like the Barista Express here, they have ways to monitor that temperature and keep it somewhat stable, but you just can't get the same temperature stability in these as something like a heat exchanger or a dual boiler. So when we're looking at the thermocoil, thermoblock, single boiler category, these will typically be cheaper machines. It is cheaper to produce. You don't have to have a massive boiler like we'll see here in a second and everything that comes along with it. And so these machines are going to be a lot cheaper than the alternatives. But then also, they can be nice if you're just the person who rarely ever has to steam milk. You can get a great single boiler espresso machine that you can have a PID monitoring and adjusting your temperature throughout. It can do all the same features as a higher end machine, but just with the limitations of switching between steaming milk and brewing espresso. I'm also sorry if you hear a noise coming from right over here. My dog has decided to take a nap and he's snoring quite loudly. Now, a step up from single boiler type machines is going to be something called a heat exchanger. This machine in particular is the Lilit Mara X. It is on loan to me from Chris's Coffee, so I want to thank them. Their website will be linked in the description down below. They have everything you need. Espresso machines, grinders, everything. Now, just by looking at this machine, you can tell there is a lot more going on, so that's part of the price difference. You have very, very high quality components in here, and it's built super well. But probably the biggest difference is this giant boiler right here. This is a huge stainless steel boiler that's wrapped in insulation, and that is going to be our main heating source. So inside of that boiler, we're gonna have a sort of heating element, and this boiler is going to fill part of the way with water, and that water is going to be heated up to boiling. The rest of the boiler is going to fill with steam. That's how we're gonna steam milk. But then these work in a really interesting way where for your brew water, since we want that to be a lot lower temperature than our steam, we actually have a separate water line going through the middle of the boiler. So our brew water is actually never inside of the boiler per se, it's in its own line just traveling through it, and that's how it's getting heated up. That water is then cycling like through the group head here on an E61 machine. It's keeping that heated up, cycling through, and it has a much better system for heating water. And also we are able to brew espresso and steam milk at the same time on these machines because those two lines are kept separate. Now another benefit with heat exchangers versus single boilers is that you're gonna have a much larger boiler being able to give you much more steaming power. So whereas this machine can take about 45 seconds to steam milk, this one can take as quick as like 15 seconds. Now one of the biggest complaints with heat exchange machines is that usually your brew temperature is being decided by your steam boiler temperature because that's how it's being heated up. So if you want more steam power, that's usually going to give you a higher brew temperature. And then also if this machine is sitting idle for a while and we have hot water being cycled through a lot, then that water is going to get super hot. So you need to do a cooling flush in order to get it down to a more reasonable brewing temperature. And that can give you some inconsistencies and just make your brewing process a little bit more difficult. Now going up from the heat exchange system, we get to something called dual boilers. And those work by having two of these boilers in the back of the machine. One is just for brew water, one is just for steam. And so you are getting full control over both of those elements, and each one can be dialed in specifically to how you would like them. So you not only can brew and steam milk at the same time on those machines, but you can also set them independently of one another. And on some machines, you can even say, turn off the steam boiler altogether if you know you're not gonna use it, and just use the brew boiler, saving you on some energy costs and efficiency on the machine. The only downsides really of a dual boiler are going to be it's obviously more expensive because you're gonna have more mechanics going into that machine, but also they're usually going to be maybe a little bit bigger because you have to fit two of these in there, not just one. So sometimes dual boiler machines can use smaller boilers, so you'll get less steam power out of them. So that can be a trade-off going from a heat exchange to a dual boiler machine. So we've gone over all the main types of espresso machine boilers. So which one is best for you? Who would be interested in a thermocoil, thermoblock, single boiler machine? I would say anyone who is first on a budget, or you're just sort of getting into the game, not sure how much money you want to devote to it. Well, these machines can be a great option. You can still get really good espresso. You can still steam milk, even though you can't do those at the same time. I've been working with this machine, the Breville Barista Express, for a few years now, and it's served me just perfectly fine. These machines can be great. They're great to learn on. They're cheaper. I am all for single boiler machines. Now moving up from there, you get to the heat exchange machines, and these are great for someone looking to spend a little more money that they know they want to be able to brew and steam milk at the same time. Usually with these machines, you get more control over your brewing temperature. You can do pressure profiling if that's something you want to get into. You can just get a lot more control out of these machines. Now they are going to be more expensive than a single boiler machine, but they definitely can be quote affordable. And if you are someone who maybe is primarily focused on espresso brewing and you want the ability to steam milk at the same time, but maybe don't do it as often, this machine, the Mara X, is going to be great for you. Or if maybe you care a little bit less about espresso quality, you don't need to be able to dial every little thing in, and you want to get good steaming power, then heat exchange machines are going to be great for you. Now moving up from there, going into dual boilers, I mean, if you have a larger budget, you know exactly what you're looking for, and you just want full control over everything from espresso brewing to your steaming. And they're great machines for the person who really wants to be able to control everything in their espresso process. So that's our quick rundown of espresso machine boilers. I hope that this video was helpful for you. If you have additional questions, please let us know in the comments down below. We are happy to help. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, happy brewing.